Well, good afternoon. This is the Midday News on Rajya Sabha TV. I'm Ashwarya with you. All the big developing stories at the top of one coming up ahead. Let us start with the headlines. Supreme Court clears way for construction of Ram Temple at Ayodhya, gives 2.77 acre disputed land to deity Ram Lalla in a unanimous verdict, says the Sunni Waqf Board failed to establish its case in the Ayodhya dispute. Supreme Court's five-judge constitution bench directs center to form a trust within 3 months to build the temple, says the Sunni Waqf Board be given a five-acre plot at an alternate location to build mosque. Supreme Court's decision should not be seen as a matter of a victory or loss, says Prime Minister Narendra Modi, appeals to people to maintain peace and harmony. Home Minister Amit Shah welcomes decision. Prime Minister Narendra Modi to inaugurate Kartarpur corridor shortly, says everyone must vow to imbibe teachings of Guru Nanak. Thanks Pakistan Prime Minister for respecting the sentiment of Indian pilgrims. And very severe cyclone Bulbul to make landfall in West Bengal late this evening to unleash heavy rains and strong winds. 34 NDRF teams deployed in Bengal and Odisha. The biggest story this afternoon, the Supreme Court's landmark judgment on Ayodhya title suit has paved the way for the construction of Ram Mandir. In a unanimous verdict, the five-judge constitution bench gave the entire disputed 2.77 acre land to Ram Lalla Virajman for the Ram Temple. The Supreme Court directed the centre to set up a trust in 3 months to formulate scheme for the construction of Ram Temple at the site. The apex court has asked the centre to grant some representation to the Nirmohi Akhara in the trust. The top court directed the centre and the UP government to allot 5 acres of alternate land to be given to Sunni Waqf Board at a prominent place for building of a mosque. The Supreme Court had dismissed the claim of the Shia Waqf Board. The court also dismissed Nirmohi Akhara's claim, saying that it is not a shibet of deity Ram Lalla and their suit was barred by limitation. And delivering the verdict, Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi said that the ASI report showed that the underlying structure below the disputed site was not of Islamic religion. The apex court said that the faith of the Hindus that Lord Ram was born at the demolished structure is undisputed.
Court has dismissed the suit of Nirmohi Akhada and have not believed them as Shibayat. That's the most crucial part. Apart from that, the Muslim parties have been given 5 acres of land for construction of a mosque in any prominent area in Ayodhya, and the central government and the state government has to decide as to where they have to give that land.
देखिए ऐसा है ना कि हम इससे पहले भी कहते हैं कोर्ट ने जो भी कहा है वो ठीक कहा है, हम उसका सम्मान करते हैं. ये जिम्मेदारी सरकार की है, वो कहा देती है कहा नहीं देती है, क्योंकि हम कोर्ट का सम्मान करते हैं, पहले भी करते थे आज भी करते हैं. हमें चाहते हैं ये मसला हिंदुस्तान का बहुत अहम था वो आज खत्म हो गया.
नॉट सेटिस्फाइड विद जजमेंट एट ऑल, बट वी विल डिस्कस इट. वी रिस्पेक्ट द एंड वी अपील टू द नेशन टू ऑब्जर्व कॉम एंड क्वाइट.
एंड एट दिस मोमेंट आरएसएस चीफ मोहन भागवत इज स्पीकिंग. लेट्स कट अक्रॉस लाइव.
अनुरूप परस्पर विवाद को समाप्त करने वाली पहल सरकार की ओर से शीघ्रतापूर्वक होगी, ऐसा हमें विश्वास है. अतीत की सभी बातों को भुलाकर हम सभी श्री राम जन्मभूमि पर भव्य मंदिर के निर्माण में साथ मिलजुल कर अपने कर्तव्यों का निर्वाह करें. कुछ है पूछना तो? जिसके हाथ में माइक उसका प्रश्न।
मोहन जी, मेरा नाम रवि त्रिपाठी है, मैं जी न्यूज से हूँ। मेरा सवाल यह है कि अब जब फैसला आ गया है तो राम जन्मभूमि जो न्यास था, जो काम कर रहा था, उसका क्या होगा? जो पत्थर वहां तराशने का काम चल रहा था, क्या आप लोग सरकार द्वारा जो ट्रस्ट बनाया जाएगा उसको ये सौंपा जाएगा? क्या होगा आगे की गतिविधि क्या होगी?
अब वो आगे की गतिविधि जैसे जैसे बनती जाएगी वैसे वैसे उसके रास्ते निकलते जाएंगे। उसमें कोई यही होना चाहिए वही होना चाहिए ऐसा आग्रह हमने नहीं किया है। स्थान दिया है राम जन्मभूमि न्यास को, सरकार को न्यास बनाने के लिए कहा है, तो सभी को मिलजुल कर मंदिर बनाना है तो निकलेंगे रास्ते।
मान्य, मेरा सवाल है कि जो कोर्ट की तरफ से ये कहा गया कि जो विवादित बस के बारे में जितनी जिसे चर्चा हो रही थी उसको मान लिया गया कि ये राम मंदिर का है और राम आस्था जो है उसके साथ साथ उसके पॉइंट भी हैं। अब जो मुस्लिम ट्रस्ट के जो भी हैं उनको जो ये दिया गया है 5 एकड़ की जमीन, जो इस सारे विवादित भूमि और जो चर्चा के विषय की जो भूमि थी उससे अलग किया गया है, क्या संघ की भूमिका इसमें होगी कि जो बात आपने पहले भी कही है कि सारे लोगों को एक साथ मिलकर इस सारी चीज़ों को आगे बढ़ाना चाहिए, इसमें क्या आपकी भूमिका होगी?
तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट का निर्णय है ना, उसको तो हम स्वीकार कर रहे हैं। मैंने विजयादशमी के भाषण में भी किया था कि ऐसे मामलों में जो कोर्ट का निर्णय होता है मान्य करना चाहिए, हम मान्य कर रहे हैं। आगे उसकी प्रोसेस चलेगी तब ये सारे प्रश्न आएंगे। जो भी है अंतिम इस स्टेटमेंट में जो हमने कहा है ये हमको झगड़ा विवाद अब समाप्त करना है।
So that was RSS Chief Mohan Bhagwat addressing a press conference after the Supreme Court's historic verdict. Now let's get more details. Akhilesh Suman is now joining us live from the Supreme Court. Akhilesh, so the disputed land in Ayodhya will now be given to a government-run trust for the building of a temple, and a 5-acre plot at a prominent site is going to be given for a mosque. Just take us through the key points of the Supreme Court's verdict today.
You know, first, you know, that the judgment was expected for many days that it should end the dispute, and it has come with consensus. That is the best thing, because if you have a dispute, you have a redressal mechanism, and since Supreme Court is the apex body for redressal of all the disputes, so Supreme Court has come, and Supreme Court has come with consensus. So the key point, the first key point that the temple will be built at the site that was demanded by the Hindu people, and Supreme Court has told with historical things, ASI findings, that yes, there should be temple at this site. But also keeping in mind the sentiment of the Muslim people, Supreme Court has told that 5-acre land should be given to the Muslim community for building a mosque at prominent place. So I think sentiment of both the communities have been taken care of by the Supreme Court. And you know, I have also inquired with many Muslim scholars, and Muslim scholars told that, you know, the mosque have been shifted in many places, in many countries. Like if you go want to know about the Shia country, Iran has shifted its mosque. And in Saudi Arabia also mosque have been shifted. Recently in Dubai, actually, there is a Coca-Cola auditorium where a big event is being organized, and there is a mosque just beside it. So mosque has been shifted to another place for that period. So it is not something that is very new for the community whose place of worship has been changed. So I think the Supreme Court has taken care of all the aspects, and Supreme Court has told that we are not going with the belief of some people. We are going with the ASI finding. Yes. And ASI finding says is based on facts that has been taken care of by excavation. So right. I think Supreme Court has made it very clear to all the parties concerned that it is not a religious issue. It is an issue that was disputed between the two parties. Yes. And, Nirmohi Akhara has been not given any right. You know, Shia Waqf Board has not been given any right. So yes. there are two parties in both the communities who have been told to keep aside, that yes. You don't have any right on all these things. So I think a trust will be built, and yes. It will be built under the, supervision of the government. And mm-hmm. then the building of a temple will go on, and Muslim community will also decide where to build the mosque and how to build the mosque. So I think this is the judgment, and this judgment is historical, you can say.
Absolutely, an historic judgment by the Supreme Court today. Thank you so much, Akhilesh, for all those updates there. And after the historic verdict by the Supreme Court, Putting an end to the decades-old dispute, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that the judgment should not be viewed as a matter of victory or loss for anyone. He said that this is the time for everyone to strengthen the feeling of patriotism. He appealed to the people to maintain peace and harmony. Prime Minister Modi had appealed for a calm ahead of the judgment as well. And Home Minister Amit Shah has also welcomed the apex court's decision. He said that the judgment will strengthen the unity, integrity and the rich cultural heritage of India. He also urged all the communities to maintain peace. Union Minister Nitin Gadkari also welcomed the Supreme Court's decision. All right, let's get a perspective on the Supreme Court's judgment. We have with us senior journalist Ashok Tandon joining us in the studio. A very good afternoon, sir, and thank you so much for joining us here on Rajya Sabha TV, sir. So the Supreme Court announced a landmark verdict in the case today. Of course, this being a religious and political flashpoint, you know, that has the cast a shadow on the country for decades now. This was, of course, a unanimous verdict. So what is your take on the verdict today?
You see, it's certainly a very historic judgment. And the very fact that the highest court of the land has given a verdict which is unanimous, that again is very significant. But let's not forget that the verdict is not one-sided at all. If the verdict had been only in favor of a Ram temple at Ayodhya, then it could have been described as one-sided. Now, the Supreme Court has taken cognizance of the sentiment of the Muslims also, and that is why 5-acre land now the government will have to allot for construction of a mosque in and around Ayodhya. I think this is a very fair judgment, and I personally feel the role of the committee which was trying for an out of the court settlement also has some bearing on this order, because they had submitted a report to the Supreme Court, and there were indications which were coming out in the media that perhaps the Sunni Waqf Board has agreed in principle to construct a mosque outside the disputed area. And that area happens to be only 2.77 acres, and in against that, now they will be getting 5 acres of land to construct a mosque. So I personally feel the trust which the government may like to form will have members like Sri Sri Ravi Shankar and others. So I think it's a very amicable judgment, which that's why it has been welcomed by all sections of the society. And particularly, I think the very significant aspect is that the claim of the Narmohi Akhada and Shia Waqf Board have been rejected. So therefore, now the party which remained was the Nyas as well as the Sunni Waqf Board. Both may be feeling satisfied, and I personally feel the Sunni Waqf Board will sooner or later will come out with a statement welcoming the judgment and accepting the verdict, and I think the whole issue will end, and henceforth this site will not be called as a disputed site.
Absolutely. And sir, while delivering the verdict, you've been mentioning how it was important for the Supreme Court to take care of the sentiments from both the sides and all the sides rather. But how crucial were the findings of the Archaeological Survey of India in the case, you know, which had actually confirmed that a structure did exist underneath the mosque?
See, when the court was looking at this entire issue from the sentimental point of view or the faith aspect of it, they respected the faith of both the Hindus and the Muslims. And once they accepted that the faith is a matter of fact, so therefore they did take into account how to deal with the sentiments of the Muslim. That is exactly why they have given 5 acres of land for construction of a mosque. When it came to the sentiments of the Hindu, they went into the archaeological survey findings, and that's why it has been quoted extensively from the Archaeological Survey of India's finding. Well, there did exist the Hindu temple beneath that structure, and there was beyond any iota of doubt, it got proved that whatever lied beneath the structure which got demolished was this, the structures which were not Islamic at all. And they may not be, all this structure may not be part of a temple, but all this structure had the bearing of a Hindu culture. So therefore, this 2.77 acre, they had no hesitation in allotting it to the Hindus for construction of a temple. So I think this, the sentiments, the religious faith, all the has been respected by the Supreme Court. You know, when the judgment will come in detail, we will see that how the Supreme Court has valued the religious diversity in this country, the faith of the people to worship freely in this country. And I think in true credentials of secular India, all aspects have been covered by the Supreme Court in its judgment. But right now, we have only the operative part of it. I think this needs to be welcomed by all sections of the society. And I'm sure that the Sunni Waqf Board will come out in and welcome this judgment and accept the verdict that let mosque be constructed somewhere else with the 5 acres of land.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, sir, for that perspective on that big story. And of course, ahead of the verdict, there were appeals for peace, including from the Prime Minister. And what we saw was a very mature response from all the leaders and from people in general, with no report of any untoward incident. Thankfully, a very heartening sign for our democracy. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us. And now let's cut across to Kartarpur, because our reporter, Panchanand Mishra, is joining us from Dera Baba Nanak. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is going to inaugurate the Kartarpur corridor in a short while from now. Let's get all the updates from Panchanand. Panchanand, what are the updates? What is happening as far as the inauguration is concerned?
First of all, I want to tell you that since morning, we are seeing the enthusiasm among Sikh pilgrims who wants to witness this entire corridor, which is new built corridor. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi reached here around 1 hour back in the area of Dera Baba Nanak. First, he addressed the gathering, and after it, he took the langar, and then after, in the last ceremony, he is now at this terminal, which is very very near to that Pakistan border. And after inaugurating this this facility center, he will flag off this first jatha, which is going to Kartarpur inside Pakistan border. So in the short while, we will see that, and all enthusiasm and all the Sikh pilgrims who are here from different parts of Punjab, from villages, in tractors, in buses, we are seeing that, and they are saying that it's like a dream come true. Much awaited demand was that this Kartarpur corridor should open, and they might be able to go inside Pakistan and pray Guru Nanak Dev, because Kartarpur Gurdwara is a place where Guru Nanak Dev spent the 18 years of his life, when up to his death. So it's very important and significant. And as we sent the visuals from here, people right now, they were able to see the Kartarpur Gurdwara only through this binoculars, but now they will be able to go inside Pakistan through this newly built corridor of around 7.5 kilometers, which is 3.5 kilometer in Indian side, and then after 4 kilometer in Pakistan side. So it's a historical moment, and also enthusiasm is looking all over in the Punjab.
Absolutely. And even as we speak, Panchanand, we can see those visuals on our television screen. We were seeing those visuals, of course, visual of Prime Minister Narendra Modi there. He is going to inaugurate the corridor on the Indian side. And initially, he had also addressed the crowds, where he thanked Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan for understanding India's sentiment as he inaugurated the integrated check post of Kartarpur corridor. So it's a historic people-to-people initiative between India and Pakistan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi there, those visuals live coming in from Gurdaspur, where he's inaugurating the Kartarpur corridor. Panchanand, now, we saw earlier Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressing the crowds, where he thanked Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan for understanding India's sentiment. What more did he say at in that speech?
Yes, the most important point was that Prime Minister Narendra Modi thanked Imran Khan, Prime Minister of Pakistan, for opening this corridor, because in the recent times we saw that the tension between two countries, the relation is not so good. But opening of this Kartarpur corridor, and there was a consensus around 1 year back, and after this consensus, the MOUs were signed, and in the last 6 months, this corridor was built by NHAI from the coordination from center to state government. And it's a like achievement for here, especially for the Sikh pilgrims, Sikh community, because the enthusiasm we are seeing here is like much like anything else. So the important thing is that it's like connecting people from here, India, to Pakistan through this corridor, and the people are expecting that there may be a strain in relationship, but this corridor may be a bridge of peace between the two countries. So this is an important occasion where Prime Minister Narendra Modi thanked Prime Minister of Pakistan and also the workers in the Pakistan who were involved in building this entire corridor. However, there is a much remaining work from Pakistan to build the bridge, actually the road, but there is the now Kachcha Rasta from the Pakistan from where this first Jatha will go, and the buses will go to the Pakistan, and this is the first Jatha where around 550 pilgrims will go, which includes Chief Minister of Punjab and also the personalities like Navjot Singh Sidhu and other VVIPs. But in the other times, in the other days, 5,000 pilgrims can go, and with the passport and this entry fees. So it's important. The people here are not bothered about this entry fees of $20,
right,
but they wanted to visit Panchanan, that Kartarpur
even as
to pray Guru Nanak Dev.
We are witnessing those visuals, that historic moment, Prime Minister Narendra Modi there inaugurating the Kartarpur corridor. Now this, of course, coming 3 days before the 550th anniversary of founder of Sikhism, Guru Nanak Dev. And those live visuals that we are getting from Gurdaspur, of course, it is a historic day, a historic moment there. And you can see the Punjab Chief Minister Amrinder Singh there, Harsimrat Kaur Badal, Union Minister, is also there. And of course, they are among the first group of 550 pilgrims who will travel to Kartarpur. And former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh is also there, actor-turned-politician Sunny Deol. They are, of course, one of that group of 550 pilgrims. Let's go across now to before we go to our reporter, let's see those live visuals there of the inauguration. And after the construction of this corridor, Gurudwara Darbar Sahib in Kartarpur in Pakistan will become easily accessible to the Sikh pilgrims. And earlier, Prime Minister Narendra Modi also expressed his gratitude to Pakistani Prime Minister. He also expressed gratitude to the Punjab government and Shiromani Gurudwara Prabandha Committee and everyone, he said, who helped to build this corridor, and that too in due time. Remember, this is the ceremony that is being held on the Indian side, and Pakistan will hold a separate event on the other side of the border, with the Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan declaring it open from the other end of the Kartarpur corridor. And Prime Minister will also inaugurate the passenger terminal building, that is the integrated check post, and that is where the pilgrims who will get a clearance really to travel through the corridor. And those visuals there, Prime Minister Narendra Modi speaking to former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh. This is the group of first batch of pilgrims who will be traveling to Kartarpur. And earlier, before the inauguration ceremony, Prime Minister Modi had offered prayers at the Ber Sahib Gurdwara at Sultanpur Lodhi as well. So this is the 4.5 long corridor which now connects Dera Baba Nanak Shrine in Punjab's Gurdaspur with Darbar Sahib in Kartarpur. Now this Kartarpur is a small town about a few kilometers from the international border. It is located in Narewal district of Pakistan's Punjab province. And this place is really, really significant because this was the place where the founder of Sikhism, Guru Nanak Dev, is believed to have spent the last 18 years of his life. And the significance of this corridor, of course, is huge, not only for Sikhs, the Sikh pilgrims, but for the entire country and also relations between India and Pakistan. Of course, this corridor is going to facilitate visa-free movement. But we do know that at this moment, Indian pilgrims are required to carry their passports. So those live visuals, historic moment there. Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurating the Kartarpur corridor. So there were number of hiccups really that happened ahead of the inauguration. But just 3 days ahead of the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev, a historic moment with Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurating the Kartarpur corridor, which will facilitate visa-free movement for the Indian pilgrims. So there were a number of hiccups initially. We saw there was some sort of delay as well when India had objected to the service charge that the Pakistan said it would impose. But that disagreement had led to some delay. But at the end of the day, we are witnessing that historic moment with Prime Minister Narendra Modi there inaugurating the Kartarpur corridor. And with that, we wrap up this edition of Midday News. Thanks so much for your time.